Hello everyone, this is Akash Chauhan, and in today's lecture we will discuss about operator overloading. So to understand what is operator overloading, let me take an example, okay, so that we can understand overloading eventually. So in a practical way, we can understand what would be the operator overloading at the end, okay. So let me take an example. So guys, I have created a testing class, and in this testing class, I have created two A and B variables, right? And in the public area, I have defined a set data method. And in the set data, okay, let me make it a void method, okay. And the set data method is taking X and Y as a parameter. And it is setting A and B for both these values for this testing class. The another function we have this display. If this function will be called, then the value stored in A and B will be on console. So this is the testing class. We have not discussed anything regarding the operator overloading. So wait for it. So what I'll do, I will create a main function and I will call these methods. First of all, I'll call set data to populate A and B, and then I will call display method, and then we will look at the further part of the program. Okay, so let me write main method. So guys, this is main method, and in main method I'm taking three object of testing class. Okay, it means T1 would be having A and B, T2 would be having separate A and B, T3 would be having separate A and B in the memory. Okay, so what I did, I am calling set data method for T1. So what it would do, it would populate the value A and B to 1 and 2. Same for T2, it would populate the value 3 and 4 for T2 object. And in the T3 objects, what I am trying to do, I am adding up those two, these, you know, objects, and then I am calling the T3 display method. But I think this we know that the addition operator would expect both left and right operand to be primitive type in general. Okay, but here T1 and T2 are of testing data type or the complex data type. Okay, so in that case, how the compiler would behave? Because compiler would understand this statement as T1 would be a permitted data type and T2 would also be permitted data type, which is not so. In our program, we have taken T1 and T2 as testing object. So if I run this code, okay, it would show the error over here. And it would say something like that T1 and T2 are of testing objects, not the operand type. So let me run this code and see the output. Okay, so the error is over here, and to know the error, let me show you. It is saying no match for operator +1, operand type are testing and testing, and it is saying it is error. So the error is no match for operator plus. I will explain about it soon, but it is also saying operand types are testing and testing, which is not permitted by the compiler. That is why it is showing the error. So it is saying that compiler would understand this statement as this would be integer type, let's say primitive data type. So we are saying integer, and this would also be integer. Compiler would not understand if it is a object or complex data type, right? So instead of doing that, what I'll do, I will call add method, okay, and pass T2 in that. So to do so, let's look at it very carefully, okay. What I'm doing, I'm calling T1 add function, and it would return whatever it would return, it would store in T3, and T3 is of testing type. It means this add method return type would be testing, right? And also the input parameter is of also testing type. Okay, so again it would be testing. We say test, this is actually a function. So in that, what it would do, it is saying add t1 to t2. Okay, so t1 is the caller object, okay, and t2 is the parameterized object. So the we can access, so as you know this function would return testing. So let me create a temporary testing object. You would know why we have created it, because at the end we have to return this object because the return type is testing. Okay, so if I want to populate temporary A, okay, temporary A means testing, temporary is the testing type of object, and A and B are the variables inside temp. So what would be the value of temp? A type caller A, and this is the parameterized, okay, this is the parameterized object, and take A of that as well. I hope you are clear. So it is adding two A's. The first A is of caller, and the second one is of T2. It means it would be adding 1 and 3. If I write same for B, it would add 2 and 4. So for the B, for B, the command would be, so for B, the command would be, this is caller variable, this is the parameterized variable, and this is temporary variable. Okay, so, and at the end I am returning temp. So instead of writing that t3 equal to t1 plus t2, if we write this, it would not throw any error, and it would add element and return that data into t3, and the t3 display function would be called, and the display function is printing those values. So it would print the add of 1 and 3 and 2 and 4, 4 and 6 would be there. So let me run this code to know the output. Okay, so answer is 4 and 6. So far, if I want to add two objects, so what I can do, I can simply create a function, and I can pass a object in that function and return the object. Okay, but this would also be great. What if I can, you know, instead of using add, I can use the operator as well. But the compiler would say the name of the function would always be either character type or digit, or it can start from underscore, but not with any operator. So if I want to make the name of the function like the operator, so it would help us. So why I'm interested in, you know, making the name of the function like an operator, so it would be super easy. So if I simply write t1, okay, t1, and I'm calling plus, so it seems look like t1 plus t2, it would be similar to that. And there is a way to do it in C++. How to do it? If I simply write operator before any operator the compiler can understand, then it would create it as a function. So if you use like that, then what you would do, you simply, instead of writing that, you simply write operator plus, and it would behave like same. But the in C++ compiler would give you a choice to even delete this dot, delete even this operator, and then these brackets as well. So if you look at it, this is exactly where we have started our program, and it was showing the error at that point of time. If you remember, it was saying that the plus is expecting both operands to be primitive type, and you are sending testing type. But if I write my program like this, okay, then it would not throw any error, and it would also give the exact result what we have calculated earlier. So let me run this code to know the output. Again, it is 4 and 6. So let me explain it again. So wait for it. Okay, so this was our program. In that, we are calling add function, passing t2, and this is the caller object. What I want to achieve is, if I want to, you know, make the name as an operator of a function or the member function. So to do so, what do you need to do? You can also do that if you simply can replace your function name with the operator. In C++, there is a way if you can use the operator before any operator, the compiler can understand cross, minus, divide. Okay. But if you pass any operator like hash, it would say that the compiler wouldn't understand that you are making it a name for that, because it is not allowed. Okay. So the operator, only operator that compiler can understand, like plus, subtraction, or any such like that, like dollar, it would accept. And for like plus, it would accept. The hash, it would not accept. Okay. And also, if you want to remove, you don't need to use operator over here. Operator over here, you can simply remove it with the dot as well. And not only that, you can remove these open and close bracket sides as well. So now it is saying that even if you provide me testing objects, I have a handler function for that. Okay. The compiler just not understand the primitive data types, but also the testing data type operands as a left and right side of the operator. So this is the main thing. So now I am able to add these objects. So if you pay little attention, for this operator, you need two operands. In this case, the operands are testing type. So when you need two operands, it is a binary operator. So, and binary operator overloading. Why I'm saying it's overloading? Because if t1 and t2 are of integer type, then the compiler can understand. But if they are testing type, even if it is the same statement, compiler can understand if I can provide this operator, this type of function, then compiler can also understand the same logic you have written for the objects as well. So we have overloaded. Even if we are using the same plus operator for integer type, it would behave differently. For object type operands, it would behave differently because we have written a separate function for that. So we have overloaded our plus operator, and it is expecting two operands. It means it's a binary operator. Operators like if you simply want to store t1++, okay. So if you pay little attention on this thing, this is not a binary operator. This is a unary operator, because it requires only one operand. In that case, it is asking for two operands at left and right side. But here, it is expecting only one operand. Even if it's a post-increment or pre-increment like this, they both are same. And they are unary operator overloading. So in my next lecture, or I will discuss about the unary operator overloading. This is simply the binary operator overloading. Okay. So thank you so much, guys, for today's lecture.